They
could
are.
Be non-violent Muslims.
We have no way to vet them out. There's no record on them from the country they come from. Just like the speech he gave here in America, he's like, we got to shut these borders out so we can figure out who these people are.
Yeah, and it's interesting, too. Like, my wife and her entire family are Lebanese.
Okay.
Now, you could, if you didn't know any better, look at them and say, ooh, bunch of Middle Eastern Muslims.
Yikes.
But actually, her family fled Lebanon because they were Christian.
Say, that's what happens.
Yeah, they
you got to get out of Dodge if you so you want to do the you're talking about the clip from Deface the Nation this morning?
Yeah.
And open borders, as we're talking about borders, you want to
the Brexit thing?
Yeah.
So yeah, the question's in there?
Yeah, the question's in there too. Okay.
Let's hear this.
This is on Deface I don't even know what's it called?
Deface the Nation. Oh, Face the Nation.
Oh, Face the Nation. I called Deface the Nation so long I didn't know if it was something else.
There any? I mean, there are some regrets we see, but is there any chance this could be reversed at all?
I don't see how. The real tragedy of what's just happened is that 17 million British people have given their political classes a mandate for something that cannot be delivered. They want continued prosperity, selling tons of stuff in and out of Europe to be a global free trading power, but they want to close the borders to any foreigners that we don't want to come in, and that can't be delivered. And so they've been lied to. So if you think this is the end of the anger, this is the beginning of the anger. Because we just saw a revolt against the experts and the elites cannot now deliver what the people have demanded.
All right.
What a liar. You explain to me, why can't that be delivered? So let me rephrase what he just said. He said that...
In English.
not in British. In American. And what he said was...
America!
So there's this false dichotomy that he set up. This absolutely false. It's not even... Instantly, as soon as I heard it, I was like, this is the most obvious false dichotomy I've ever seen. So you can't, what he's saying is you can't have the prosperity of free trade between nations and also have open, or I should say closed borders where people are not allowed to come in and out. But America's been doing that for centuries.
What was Britain doing before this?
They were doing that for centuries. They were the biggest global empire for a long time.
Oh, yeah. Britain was the capital of the world.
The British Empire.
Yeah.
And you couldn't just waltz in and out of that country like the wind. And they were trading amongst other countries in a free trade. So what is he talking about? He literally just lied to everybody saying that this cannot happen.
You know, that's funny he said that because with the example of America, there are countries around the world, for whatever reason, these people can't just hop on a jet airliner and come to America.
Okay.
They can't just say, hey, I think I'm going to take a holiday. I think I'm going to America.
Okay.
You just can't do that.
I imagine you'd get a passport.
Okay, maybe. Or if you're approved for a passport, or maybe your country's not dealing, you know, back and forth. I'm just saying there's places where you can't fly into.
Right. If you were literally in Tehran, you would not be able to just jump on a plane that goes directly to America.
Right. So my whole point is that this is nothing new.
He's making it sound like this is unprecedented.
And we shut the borders down in America for assimilation for 50 years?
At least a good 50 years.
Right after World War I, for about 40 or 50 years, we shut the border down. Nobody could come in.
It wasn't until Ted Kennedy opened it back up in the 60s.
And we were the wealthiest, one of the wealthiest.
And we traded with other nations.
Everybody.
What is he talking about? And Great Britain did it for centuries themselves. The guy, I cannot believe he was not challenged on that.
Not even. He's like, well, we'll have to see what happens.
Leave it at that.
Yeah, thanks for coming on the show, man.
Yep. Watching Deface the Nation.
What you just said was
indisputable.
It's mind blowing. My mind's been blowed
because it's so true.
So the truth, speaking truth. Truth to
power.
Is that what they said? Truth to power.
Oh, what an idiot.
Wow. And so this is what America's news media has become, just pathetic, old.
Left unchallenged.
Right. And
it's
then
terrible.
I got one last soundbite on Great Brit and the leave, the separation, the divorce. This is by Lou Dobbs. I'm starting to get into Dobbs.
Oh, he's awesome.
The British have made Britain great again, to coin a phrase. What we've witnessed is a true populist revolt in the UK, despite the gross intrusion of President Obama and Hillary Clinton, who strongly urged the British to stay in the Union. Obama even meddling in the politics of the UK as he insisted while on British soil that they vote to remain, and both Clinton and Obama turned out to be on the wrong side of history. With the Brits unplugging from the European Union, the EU may be nearing an end itself. The globalists are losing. This referendum wasn't simply about being part of a 28-member European Federation. It was a referendum on national sovereignty, self-determination, individualism, and resisting further centralization of power, status ideology, and government structure.
And that is what everybody has looked to America for. That's what America is. That's what America has always been about. And everybody around the world wants to come here, not because we think we're all high and mighty on our horse. It has nothing to do with us. They want to come here for that freedom and that self-determination to lead their lives the way they want to live. If you want to be gay in America, be gay. If you want to be straight, be straight. If you be whatever you want to be, you want to be Bruce Jenner and Caitlyn Jenner and goofiness, whatever. Nobody
cares. You want to get a chopped adictomy and a doctor's willing to do it?
Nobody cares in America. So come on, do it. However, if you want to do it over in those other nations that might wind up dead.
Like Saudi Arabia.
They might wind up dead.
Get your head chopped off.
And people aren't clamoring to get into there.
No.
No. And why we have this mass invasion into Britain and into Europe? Because they have more of what they don't have.
Bottom line about Brexit, this is a way for British people to salvage their country from the invasion of the Middle East.
Yes.
It's as simple as that.
And the more that we all see here, and it's amazing with technology, and we talked about this last week.
It's a last-ditch effort, too, by the way. It's going to be a caliphate that's going to cause a new Ottoman Empire that stretches from Spain all the way to India.
Oh, absolutely. From the north to the south. And Great Britain just pulled the ripcord as the plane started to go down.
Oh, it's going down. The engines are on fire. Yes. The rudder has been ripped off.
Yes.
There's hydraulic fluid squirting all over the place.
Let's just cross our fingers. The canopy releases and they don't turn into goose.
Oh, yeah. He hit the canopy.
Oh,
not
man.
Good.
But they pulled the
ripcord, but here's the thing. It's slow motion. It's a two-year process.
Yeah, if the canopy doesn't get out of the way.
The canopy is there now. The ripcord's been pulled, but we don't know where this is going to end up.
Oh, poor Maverick made it, though.
Somebody could have packed the parachute backwards.
Oh, so they pulled it, the canopy leaves, and then there's no...
Oh, I got to tell you about how this one pilot died. I was a Harrier mechanic, for those of you that didn't know, in the Marine Corps. And a plane crashed, and they said the pilot ejected, but when they recovered the body after he ejected safely from the aircraft. But when they recovered him, his neck was snapped. And they were like, well, I guess we got to figure out what happened here.
Right.
Turns out when you're installing the ejection seat, it goes down these rails, two rails. And in order to keep it straight and aligned as it's exiting, there's two cables that are also attached to the seat that kind of snap or somehow come undone as the ejection seat comes out of the plane. When they installed it, those cables were crossed.
What?
Yeah. So as soon as he got all the way out of the aircraft, and by the way, you're still in your seat
right.
when this happens, the seat did a 180-degree turn instantly.
Oh, no.
So the seat turns, his head's not, it's just on his neck.
There is no way your neck, it's like somebody taking your head, like Jean-Claude
Van Damme. Yeah.
Just twisted your neck real quick and that's it.
Yeah, it's just like you see in the movies where they grab the chin and the back of the head and they
right.
go, wah!
That's it. It's all done.
Yeah, because these stupid guide cables that they could have put them in one way or they could have crisscrossed them. And they're like, I think it's this way. I don't know. Just put it on.
Right.
So that's what we're hoping that the
Great Britain doesn't snap their neck.
Make sure that we don't get our neck snapped.
Oh, wow. So Trump came out and was just, I mean, not that he was gloating, but he was making it abundantly clear that Hillary Clinton is part of the globalist movement. She is a globalist and she is a EU stay voter.
Well, she's a progressive.
Right.
And if you look at, in order to understand liberals, Democrats, progressives, communists, socialists, whatever, they're all in the same bucket. They all believe in the same thing, which is this utopian end game, right?
Right.
And if you want a very quick summary of what this utopian society, not exactly is, but some of the aspects of it, listen to the music of John Lennon in his song Imagine. And one of the things he says is that there should be no borders anywhere. It's easy if you try. So there's other things too, like no religion and all that kind of stuff. So, but big thing is borders.
Well, and you have to remove the borders in order for this entire collapse. And
Communist anthem.
We're talking about it. It's a communist anthem.
Imagine there's no heaven.
No heaven. Because we're right off the bat, religion. No.
Sees if you try.
So imagine no heaven.
No hell below us.
No hell.
So there's no responsibility, no bad. You do whatever you feel.
Above us, only sky.
So you're living this existential existence where
imagine all the people.
You have to, this is it.
There's nothing else.
Living for today. There's your existentialism right there. Was that the first verse?
Yeah.
There we go. No countries. They believe that countries are the cause of
wars.
Nothing to kill or die for.
No,
but we got to go back to religion.
Because you got to get rid of the religion. Yeah.
So.
Yeah. It's just.
That song, you got to really listen to those lyrics. And there's other examples, too, of utopianism, Marxism. It's all the same thing, by the way. And it all stems back to the beginning of time, really.
Well, because people, it's easy to live with no self-control. It's easy to do that. It's easy for me to just walk out and take something from somebody. I mean, my kids do it. We have to teach them not to do that.
Right. So the default is to just take whatever you want.
Right. To live barbaric, if you will.
Okay.
And it is hard to control yourself, but when you do, you do live a better life. You do live a more complete and better, but you have to work at it. This, he's talking about no work, no nothing, no, just living. He's talking about the Garden of Eden.
That's
Adam and Eve.
Utopians are always trying to recreate. We've talked about this early on in the show.
Oh, yeah.
Where we said that socialists, communists, progressives, they're all about progressing towards recreating the Garden of Eden. And this Garden of Eden would be maintained and run by the government, which is the problem.
And you're listening to Smith Radio, your host Brian Smith and Carrie Smith. That's SMYTH. You can follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/Smith Radio, on Twitter at Smith Radio, or just go to our website, smithradio.com. You can see the live feeds of both Twitter and Facebook, as well as every single show we've ever had. If you want to be a part of the show live on Sunday nights, 5 to 8, call in 513-888-1538. We just wrapped up the whole Brexit exit. slipped on some awesome sauce with